Hey guys, welcome to the channel Rockin' the Country. I'm Don. First, I want to give a shout out to my niece, Lindsay. She just graduated from Columbia, and she had a great career there in not only lacrosse, where she was all Ivy everything, but she's got a great job lined up, and I love her dearly. So shout out to you, Lindsay. The hat. Today, I'm reacting to a phenomenal artist and vocalist, Alison Krauss. I don't know this song. The song is Jacob's Dream, and it was recommended by Barry Ray. So shout out to you, Barry. This goes out to you and for everybody too, because Alison is just a treat. And we're going to get to see her performing in this thing. So I'm going to turn my hat around, and we're going to get straight into this here. Alison Krauss, Jacob's Dream. Here we go.
The fires were built on the highest peaks in hopes they'd see the light. Oh, Mommy and Daddy, why can't you hear our cries? The day is almost over, soon it will be night. We're so cold and hungry. Promise not to stray again from our cabin door.
The drama, the instrumentation in here is so ideal for maintaining the drama. The symbiosis or marriage that goes on between instrumentation and vocals and the lyrics is difficult to match because they're two different realms. Lyricism is different and vocals versus the instrumentation in multiple ways, not only the way we process it in our brains. What, you know, semantic memory and echoic memory and these sorts of neuroanatomical things that I think about when I hear a song like this. But not only Alison's phenomenal voice, but it's matched. There's an ideal match between the instrumentation, what they're playing, I guess the key they're playing it in, the tempo they're playing it, the number of instruments, and it just matches. Not merely the lyricism, but the way Alison is singing it. Because honestly, when you've got Alison singing on a song, it isn't up to her to catch up to the instrumentation or match that. I think any instrumentalist knows, oh my gosh, I've got to try to catch up to her. I've got to try to rise to her level so that what I'm playing and how I'm playing it matches her. Man. And it doesn't look like she's trying here, but what she's doing here is the mark of craftsmanship, of just being. She's just brilliant. Okay, and the musicians are too. Here we go.
Now Jacob David woke one night from a strange and eerie dream. He saw a path between two hills near a dark and swollen stream.
Didn't see that coming.
He told his wife he saw the boys huddled close beside a log. For two more nights the dream returned, this vision sent from God. Oh, Mommy and Daddy, why can't you hear our cries? The day
parents' worst nightmare.
We promise not to stray again from our cabin door. Jacob's wife knew of this place and said to travel here with a guide to take him there. Jacob came upon the scene and found the boys cold and still beneath the old birch tree.
Yep.
We're both up in heaven now. God is by our side.
Damn.
As you lay us down to rest in the presence of the Lord, know that we will meet you here at heaven's door. Oh, Mommy and Daddy, look past the tears you cry. We're both up in heaven. God is by our side. And as you lay us down to rest in the presence of the Lord, know that we will meet you here at
Talk about an emotional roller coaster, man. I just went through the ringer. I don't know. Some of you guys know this song. Some of you may not. Maybe it hit you the same way it hit me. I hear songs very differently when I've got the headphones on and I'm doing a reaction versus when I'm like driving in my car, you know, because your mind wanders when you're driving. It has to. You're looking at the cars in front of you. You're looking at the street signs. You're just, you know, your mind can wander into, oh, I've got to do this or that. When I'm here, I'm feeling it, I'm focused. And that was a 2-hour movie condensed and compressed down into 4 or 5 minutes. Then you take like the Meryl Streep of vocalists and Alison Krauss and the instruments, and then the storyline where you've got parents and the kids ran off. Every parent's nightmare. And I mean, I look back at my childhood and it's a miracle I'm still alive, just from even when I was 5, 6, 7 years old, almost drowning in the pool. Nobody even knew about that. But then the crazy stuff I did when I was a teenager and even into my 20s, the fact I'm alive. And then you hear this and I'm like, oh, the mom knows where they are by this oak tree. And it had grown to 1,000 folks scouring the hills to try to find them. And they find them. And you're like, oh, thank God, the parents are getting their kid back. And they only found their bodies. And then you're like, oh, man. And then the thing about, like, the theological side, the spiritual side of things, about, you know, belief in heaven and this, is that, unfortunately, part of the script is we've got to die to find out if that's right. And, you know, some people have an absolute unshakable faith that that is absolutely what's going to happen and so forth. And I don't assail that at all. I have no reason to, no basis for assailing anything that somebody believes in that way. This world is hard to get through. And anybody who's lost a child, and I'm close with a few people who have, and, you know, trying to make sense of it and trying to have hope and some meaning to life in this world after that event, it's hard to find. And when you find that, keep it. But to miss that, those children, I mean, geez. All right, so what this song was trying to capture, despite the fact, oh my God, that is, to me, that's a 9.6. I mean, you're not going to do much better in a song than what they were going for and how they put it. There's so much thought. I don't know how much practice and what rehearsals were like, but, you know, should we bring in a harmonica? I don't think so. Should we bring in this? No. How should we go with that? Should we cut this out? Add that? I don't know. It was brilliant. It was just close to perfection. So Barry Ray, thank you, my friend, for recommending that. What a journey that song was. In and out, up. Oh, they found him. Oh, they're not alive. Like, ugh. Anyway, heartrending. So that's it. All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. Leave a comment. I know some of you will because it's impossible not to with a song like that. All right. I'll see you in another video, guys. Have a great day. Keep rocking the country.